Hi friends, today I'll teach you about central sales tax CST. CST will attract in case of interstate sales. Example, when we sold the goods from Telangana state to Andhra Pradesh state, in this case CST will applicable. So not only Telangana to Andhra Pradesh, if we'll sell any product from one state to other state, the CST will applicable. The CST rate is 2%. For example, from Telangana state to we are selling goods to Chennai state customer, in that case CST 2% will applicable. So we have to collect the C form from customer. So if you will not provide C form, in this case local VAT rate will applicable based on the product. And C form, there are some forms, C forms against purchase or sales, whatever. So in case of we purchase from other state, we have to issue C form. If you are selling product to other state, so we have to collect C form. F form, branch transfer. In case of we have multiple branches, now we are transferring some goods from one branch to other branch, in that case we'll issue form along with the material. Okay, exports. H form will use, so in case if we export the goods. And I form, sales to SEZ customers. In case of the customer has registered his company under SEZ Act, in that case we have to collect I form from customer. So they have some benefits like exemption from service tax and central sales tax and local tax, local sales tax. So in that case we have to collect form I from customer. And coming to Tally, to activate CST feature in Tally ERP9 and go to a F11 feature. So from the gateway of screen here, and here statutory and taxation here, this one. Okay, this one we have to enable VAT. Okay, so enable VAT. Note 1, note 2, we cannot claim input VAT or input CST against output CST. What we have collected tax against CST billing, that total value we have to pay government. For example, the CST billing is CST, output CST value is, tax value is 5000. Now input CST, so output CST means we are selling the goods from our state to other state, in that case we are collecting tax 5000 rupees from other state, and here we are purchasing from other state, that is 3000. So here in general case VAT, if you will sell the product or purchase the product within the same state, we can claim input VAT, but here we cannot claim. So what we have collected against CST billing, the total value we have to pay government. Okay, we can't claim here input CST or input VAT. Input VAT we can claim within the state transactions, like you know, for example, VAT payable is within the state, VAT payable is 5000 and input VAT is 3000, the remaining 2000 we have to pay government. In this case we can claim, whereas if you collect CST from other state, in that case we cannot claim against CST. Okay, note 2, CST paid on purchase, the same CST value added to the product value. because we can't claim the input CST against payable. Here okay, generally entry will be CST sales entry customer account debit to sales at 2%, say CST sales and credit output CST at 2%. In case of sales entry, we can like this, we can post the transaction. In case of CST purchases, CST purchases here directly purchase account data to like that we have to post, because we can't claim. If you separate our tax also output input CST, we can't claim it. So that is the reason we are adding to the goods value. Okay, and month end adjustment entry, so here output CST is created and will debit and will pause this entry. So every month end, like so April 30th of April will post this, and so based on the due date we have to pay this. When we are paying CST payable account debit and bank, so like this we have to post the entries, and I'll show you how to post the transaction in Tally. Voucher here, say reference number, and we are selling goods to Raj Enterprises, and here CST sales, say some 1 lakh, and output CST this one. So based on the tax class, tax will calculate automatically. See, under I have created under duties and taxes, type of duties CST. Here this we have to select from VAT class, this we have to select. Okay, so based on this only it will calculate automatically. Okay, here this against form C. Okay, being goods sold. Okay, and a receipt Raj Enterprises. So if you want to see the balance of Raj Enterprises, go to balance sheet, current assets, sundry debtors, and here this is our transaction. Okay, total receivable is 1,12,500. This is how much we have to receive for this transaction, 1,02,000. Okay, and this payment entry is payment from customer, Raj Enterprises, 1,02,000. Against we given reference, which one? This one. Okay. Crediting to our bank account, being amount received from Enterprises. This we have to pay now. Output CST 2%. Here we have to post the adjustment entry voucher and go to general F7. Here output CST 2000. If you observe here, payable is 2000 and now 0. So this is adjusting to the CST payable. Every month and we have to post this entry. CST payable account 2000, being CST payable for the month of April 2017, and CST we have to pay now. So here CST payable account, how much here? It is showing 2000, and now the balance showing is 0. Here only we can able to see, not required to go and check each ledger wise. Okay, here only we can able to see, being is CST paid for the period for the month of April. Okay, like this we have to post the transactions. So, and if you want to see the reports also, we can see sales register, CST purchase or CST sales. Here we can able to see the register also. So go to display from gateway of Tally, display statutory reports, CST and CST register. Okay, here CST sales and CST purchases. So this entry will be post directly, inclusive of input VAT. Will post this entry will post. Okay, see here we can see forms receivable. Okay, any forms receivable, C form. Okay, here form type, here we can able to see from where, from which customer, this all we can able to see. Okay, like this we have to post the transaction. Right, thanks for watching this video. Thank you.